Oh, you got that video?
Hell yeah,
bro. We got the video!
Ta-da! Yo, what is up? Welcome back to another episode of Against the Formula. How you guys doing? I know what you guys are thinking. 15, 16 minute vlog. Man, it's so long. But I promise you that this is some high quality content. What you're about to witness is my first experience on the road with the Sacramento Kings. This is something I've dreamed of my whole life, to be able to travel like an NBA player, but not play in the games. But just, it's definitely an experience I won't forget. So please, without further ado, enjoy.
We got the bag. This is the camera. Pelican case, and then we got the big boy with all the clothes.
And once again, I don't know how much I really can film. I'm going for work, and I'm supposed to be working on this trip. Plus, I'm pretty new to the squad, so I can't film as much as I want to, but I want to document the moment. And the first city that we're going to is Oakland. We're playing the Golden State Warriors tomorrow. I don't know why we're flying, but it's a 40-minute flight. Should be nice and short. It's gonna be my first time flying and first time traveling with the team. My coworker, Jay Ram, is going to be helping me out and showing me around. Hopefully I can feature him on the vlogs and he's cool with it. Still surprises me how far I've come doing the things that I love, and now I'm doing it for the Sacramento Kings, which is weird. And you guys are about to see a little behind the scenes of it. Let's get it.
Filming on the nice little Sony RX100 Mark V. It's a good travel camera too, because I could do this. I can finally see myself.
I set up that shot. Well, you got that right. I just set that up. They literally got us hooked up. I don't even know what hotel this is called, but the Kings are treating me right. This is a whole different experience. Check out this room. Fight for me when I don't know what I believe. Why does everybody leave? Show me what it's like to dream. Hey, go. Sunny day here in San Francisco. We are about to do nothing, actually. We had shoot around at 10:30, but it ended up being canceled. And now I have a bunch of time before the first bus leaves at 4:30. It's time to explore the city. And by exploring the city, I mean. So I'm at lunch. I finally have some time, and every time I'm out in the city, I don't have time to see this guy. This is my cousin Brian, even though we look like brothers. And I finally get some time to see him. We're at lunch really quick before the game.
Yep.
Warriors, up, baby.
Man. Warriors. Yeah. He's a Warriors fan. What are your thoughts on the Kings right now?
No, Kings are up and coming right now. I think they're all playing hard. They got a good group of like young core talent that's gonna be like. I give them 2 or 3 years. They're gonna make a run for it.
What do you mean? We're gonna make playoffs this year?
No, I'm talking about like conference finals.
I think we're gonna meet you in the first round though. Don't you think?
Smoking bro.
Okay. Jesus. We are back at the hotel prepping for the game, and just wanted to take a moment to shout out to Brian. I know we don't really get to go out much, so it was really good to see him, grab some lunch, grab some boba, and just talk about life and stuff. And Brian was always the guy who was looking out for me because we were brown and we kind of look like brothers. But every time I come out to the city, I really don't get to see him at all, or I'm too busy to meet up. So it was really good to see him before the game, just pick at his mind about life in general. So shout out to you, Brian. Thanks for meeting me for lunch and for some boba. So pre-game, this is my first road trip, so I don't know like how all this goes, but all I know is that we have a bus at 4:15, and from there we go to the game. We watch pre-game, film pre-game, go into the game, and luckily enough, we don't leave until tomorrow. So we're set. I come back here, take a nice little sleep, and then tomorrow we go to Oklahoma City. But one of the questions I wanted to go over is what kind of camera gear I get to use with the Sacramento Kings, and I know you guys are thinking, oh, they have all this money. The common question is, what camera I get to use, or what equipment do the Sacramento Kings provide? Let's look at the camera that I get to use. I forgot I set it up already. No mama working, she be whining. Yeah, so open up and I'ma dive in. And we say, oh, spend it all. Living life like no tomorrow. So this bad boy is the Sony FS7, but this is the big boy. This is what we use for the bigger productions and for all the games. It's really, really, really nice. It's one of the professional cameras on the higher end, and it's Sony. So I'm a Sony guy, and so are a bunch of my coworkers. We're trying to convert all to Sony. Sony's nice, man. I'm excited. Tonight's the game where I get to shoot by myself. Usually I have someone to shadow at home when I'm at the Golden 1 Center. So tonight it's just me recording, capturing the good stuff.
And it all fits right in here in this little Pelican case, and I get to travel that around.
Big shout out to Brad and Devon and Kev, Garrett and Mark for letting me have this opportunity to come out here, shoot some road trip games, and get to mess around with this camera. I do this on my own. Alright, it is game time, y'all. It is time for me to leave. The bus is here. It's go time once we arrive at the arena, so I can't really film much. Hopefully we get the dub. I be happy when I'm lonely and low key. Hey. Gotta turn off the camera. I can't leave it on. Work so f***ing much, my greatest fear is I'ma die alone. Every diamond in my chain, yeah, that's a milestone. Loving it, I'm loving
people it. Calling me, asking me for money, man. The only thing I'ma give you, mother, yeah, is a dial tone. Flashback to a youngin' sipping that purple Kool-Aid. Skipping school with my homies and chief and reefer for 2 days. Running from the law, living how I'm living, f*** em all. Bumping 666, Hennessy in my cup, driving through the sticks. Who the f*** riding with me, man, the devil trying to get me. Motivated, undereducated, and hated, but finally getting cake like a happy belated. I made it the more. Work so f***ing much, my greatest fear is I'ma die alone. Every diamond in my chain, yeah, that's a milestone. People calling me, asking me for money, man. The only thing I'ma give you, motherfuckers, is the dial tone.
And another crushing defeat.
Hello.
To the Golden no State Warriors.
Yeah, we should have had that one. I wanted to share with you guys a moment really quick. This is like a new feeling for me for some reason. Maybe because it's my first time on a road trip, but note this is only my second time being in a new arena other than the Sacramento Kings arena. When the Warriors won and the buzzer rang, there was like this eruption and this energy that filled up in the arena. You could tell they're used to this. They're used to winning. They're used to coming back. They're used to, it's weird. I don't know. I think it's just because I've never experienced an L on the other team's court before, but it hurt. It hurt really bad. As a Kings fan, you know that these past games we've played against the Warriors, we definitely should have won or it's been close, which is exciting because we're keeping up with them. We're keeping up with the number one team in the Western Conference, which is really good. I just know that feeling of being used to winning will be in Sacramento soon. I'm telling you right now, guys, we're on the come up. We're keeping up with them and we're playing our hearts out. We're off to OKC tomorrow. Maybe it's cause your mom never kissed you. Muscle tissue. You bench pressing more than me's not the issue. I know you're actually weaker than that. Let's open up and get deeper than that. Like, why are you only vulnerable when no one's around? Your gym membership is not a crown. You're not so tall. Oklahoma City, we are here. There's not really much going on in OKC, that's for sure. Got my little hotel room here, but a funny thing, not very funny actually. The hotel that we're staying at is haunted. You ever heard of NBA players talk about the haunted hotel in Oklahoma City? Well, we're staying in it right now. This is the Skirvin Hilton in Oklahoma City. The story is a woman who had passed away a long time ago comes around the halls and in hotel rooms to say hello and kind of freak people out. Whatever. I slept well last night. Kind of scared, but made it through the night. We just came back from shoot around. Got to see the OKC Arena. It's very nice. The city's kind of small. I'm not gonna lie. Unfortunately, I don't get to shoot much for the vlog of players. Hopefully soon though, I get comfortable with some of them or get comfortable just with the staff that I can pop out the vlogging camera and whatnot. So for those who are wondering, yes, I get to ride the bus with them. Yes, I get to ride in the same plane with them. I get to go to the arena with them. But look at this hotel room. We are here. It's haunted. I'm about to order some room service before the game. The first bus leaves at 4 o'clock and we're ready. I'm set. Tough loss last night. I was thinking about it a lot. I think we'll bounce back. The guys were very positive at shoot around.
Got the camera set up. You guys already know. Shoot or shoot.
I would not expect myself to be at this point this time last year at all. To be with my favorite team and the time to come in to the organization is amazing. We're going to do a playoff push. We're going to make it. I'm telling you right now.
That is big time stuff right there. They don't go for the foul, they play defense.
Welcome to Minnesota.
Stuck in the maze.
Wow, so we made it here safely in Minnesota. I have to say, I have a greater appreciation for NBA players. We literally just played OKC 5 hours ago. 5 hours ago. And now, all of a sudden, we're here in Minnesota.
Everything's okay, but it's not really okay. My life's a death race. I'm in my pain with codeine rain. I'm going insane. Life's not the same.
I was wondering that.
Live too, huh?
Yes, sir.
Hey, boy. The 49ers is coming on the
hub. Oh, 49ers is my favorite team.
Yeah.
I was supposed to be in the NFL for real.
Get the shot.
Get that spin on it.
Oh, my God.
Oh, you got that video?
Hell yeah,
bro. We got the video! Ooh, we got the video! I need that!
Oh my God, it is cold, yo! It is freezing, bro! It doesn't look like it's freezing out here. But it is cold. So here's the arena right here. And our hotel's just right here, which is cool. But
It is not the business right now to walk across here.
I'm scared.
Don't slip.
Woo. Woo.
It's nice though.
So I have a little bit of time before the first bus gets here to go to the game, and I wanted to get some scenics outside. And I did want to go outside and show you guys the snow, and I wanted to enjoy, not enjoy, I'm probably not going to enjoy the snow for sure, but I brought this jacket specifically for the snow, so I have to step outside and kind of observe and take it all in. But at the same time, I'm going to get some scenics. So wish me luck. It's a different cold out there.
Here we go. It hits you. It hits you so hard when you open this door. Here we go.
Oh, this definitely isn't the business right now, man. Gotta do it for the video, gotta do it for the content. This is not the business, man. Oh my god.
I can't feel my face. I'm starting to cry. I don't think it's safe to be outside right now, but I got the shots. We gotta go to the game. Ah. Believe it or not, I was only out there for like 12 minutes. I thought I was gonna go walk around. Didn't make it anywhere. Only 12 minutes I lasted. Minnesota, you guys are crazy, man.
You good, T-minus? You can count me out, I'm counting my bullets, I'm loading my clips, I'm writing down names, I'm making a list, I'm checking it twice and I'm getting them hit. The real ones been dying, the fake ones is lit, the game is off balance, I'm back on my shit. The Bentley is dirty, my sneakers is dirty, but that's how I like it, you all on my dick. I just poured something in my cup. I've been wanting something I can feel. Promise I am never letting up. Money in your palm will make you real. Foot is on their neck, I got them stuck. I'ma give them something they can feel. If it ain't about to swat, don't give a f.
So the Kings lose here in Minnesota, 112-105, and it'll be interesting to hear in the post game.
So yeah, we went 1-2 on my first road trip with the Sacramento Kings. That last game was really bad. It was really, really rough. But nonetheless, a great experience all around. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys like seeing behind the scenes of what I have to go through before the game and kind of after the game, and how fast we have to move from location to location. So once again, I really wanted to thank Brad. I know you're watching this reel. I know you watch my videos. What's up, man? I wanted to thank Brad and the whole squad for letting me go out on a road trip. It's definitely a fun experience, and I do want to do some more in the future, and hopefully I get to share a little bit more every time I go out. The regular season for the Sacramento Kings is coming to an end here pretty soon. The chances of us making playoffs are getting a little more slim. We have about 18 to 17 more games left, and we literally need to win every single one of them to just get a chance to make the playoffs. So please, if you don't know what NBA team to root for right now, root for the Sacramento Kings. We're on the come up. Also, if you want to check out our new documentary series that our squad is making called The Run, the link is in the description below. We're kind of documenting the run basically to the playoffs to try to see if we can make it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you guys appreciate that behind the scenes look, and it's something I want to do more in the future. Hopefully get to travel with the team and get to show you guys my experience. I literally get to do what the NBA players get to do, except for playing the game. I also wanted to show you guys that this is possible for you. I mean, not if this is not your dream, but I'm just saying, if your dream is to be something or go somewhere, do something, you can get to it if you work hard enough, just like I did. I always say this, this is only the beginning. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you're new, welcome. Make sure you hit that subscribe button down below and join the movement. I'll see you guys in the next one. Jake Soriano.